إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَرْمُونَ الْمُحْصَنَاتِ الْغَافِلَاتِ الْمُؤْمِنَاتِ لُعِنُوا فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ عَظِيمٌ.
Those who falsely accuse the chaste believing women, those who are ignorant of what you are accusing them of, and they are innocent of what you are accusing them of, Allah says, for them, they have the curse in this world and the next. We want to save ourselves from curse. That's why we're talking about this verse. If you want to save yourself from la'na in the dunya and the akhirah, stop accusing people. Stop spreading rumor. Now someone might say, no, but I didn't start the rumor. I didn't start the rumor. So let me at least forward it so people can know what's going on. You know? Wallahi, we're all guilty of receiving messages and immediately we have a whole list of people, tick, 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 it's gone. Before you know it, it's beamed to 1,000 people and each one of them beams it to another 1,000. Within 15 minutes, 1 million people have that message. Where did it go from? May Allah forgive us. It's dangerous. Allah says, the source is cursed. Not only the source, anyone who was guilty of spreading it thereafter is also a party to the crime. So don't. Subhanallah. Imagine Allah is saying a person who accuses others is actually cursed in the dunya and the akhirah. And Allah says, وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ عَظِيمٌ. They are going to have a great punishment. Sometimes Allah uses alim. Alim means painful punishment. In this verse, number 23 of Surah An-Nur, Allah says, a very big punishment. May Allah protect us. A lot of us think it's light. And this is why in some of the verses, as we shall see inshallah tomorrow, Allah speaks about this and He says, تَحْسَبُونَهُ هَيْنًا وَهُوَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ عَظِيمٌ. Certain things you think they are very light, but in the eyes of Allah, they are massive, huge crime being committed and you don't know. For you, it was the forward of a message. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala safeguard us. Now, I need to speak about verse number 5 of the same surah before I close for today. And that verse is regarding what should be done if I've already committed such a crime. I've already engaged in accusing others. I can taste it in my life. A lot of the times when you're struggling with your health, with your wealth, you've got problem after problem. You have disaster with your children, with your parents. You have a problem and a difficulty. These are matters we want to save ourselves from. We go from doctor to doctor, from pillar to post, and we don't know how to safeguard ourselves. A lot of the times you need to look within you. Have you spread a rumor about someone? If the answer is yes, perhaps you have achieved that curse that Allah speaks about. Maybe you have cursed yourself by talking about others. This is why a true believer saves himself or herself by not speaking ill about others. I promise you, my brothers and sisters, if you were and if I were only to speak good about one another behind our backs, we would make a better ummah. Let's promise today. And I challenge you, behind the backs of others, no matter who they are, do you promise that you will only say good things? Alhamdulillah, even if it is your mother-in-law, by the way. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to say the best words. Look, there is a lot of goodness in every one of us, and we also make mistakes. Why only harp on the evil, making it seem like there is no goodness in the person? Speak about the good. If you don't have anything good to say, keep quiet. مَنْ كَانَ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ فَلْيَقُلْ خَيْرًا أَوْ لِيَصْمُتْ. Whoever believes in Allah and truly believes in the last day of accountability, they will only utter that which is good or remain silent, because they know if they say that which is bad, they will be held responsible in the dunya and the akhirah. So what if I've already done something? What if I'm struggling and suffering? Number one, seek the forgiveness of Allah. You know why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in verse number 5, regarding those whom He said are very sinful,
إِلَّا الَّذِينَ تَابُوا مِن بَعْدِ ذَٰلِكَ وَأَصْلَحُوا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ.
Indeed, except for those who seek the forgiveness, they engage in tawbah and they make amends, they change their ways and habits, Allah says, for them, is forgiveness, for indeed Allah is most forgiving, most merciful. Imagine a person who's done bad, they have been cursed, they are suffering in every way, they want to save themselves. The best way to save yourself from calamity on earth and in the next life is by seeking the forgiveness of Allah. And seeking the forgiveness of those whom you have wronged. Say, look, you know what, my brother, I wronged you. I'm very sorry, forgive me. Please, I realize my mistake. But do you know what aslahu means? Aslahu means to make amends thereafter. If you have backbitten about someone, spoken bad about them, you now need to go around speaking good about them. You need to undo the bad that you did. You went around and you spread bad. You spoiled their name in community and society. Now that you've asked Allah's forgiveness, you must go back to the people whom you went to spoil that person's name and said, you know what, I was wrong. What I said was actually wrong. And it was bad for me to say it. May Allah forgive me and may that person forgive me too. It is not easy to do that. For us, it's easy to ask Allah's forgiveness sometimes. But we are sometimes very proud. Our ego prohibits us from going up to the person. Please forgive me, my brother. Forgive me. Forgive me, my sister. I have wronged you. That's not easy. And Allah says, if you're ready to do that, we will ensure that you have mercy in this world and the next. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all.